समारंभां ज्ञान संबंध मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis sitting with us around the world at this moment. 505 places through Nityananda TV and 44 places through a video conferencing having Nayana Deeksha in 184 cities in 27 countries around the world. Cities sitting with us in two-way video conferencing having Nayana Deeksha. Thiruvannamalai, Los Angeles, Arunachalam, Oklahoma, Somanatham, Guadalupe, Rameshwaram, Ohio, Prayag, San Jose, Madurai, Hyderabad, Bahyanagaram, Seattle, Chidambaram, Kulim, Malaysia, Adayar, Chennai, Toronto, Kailasam, Phoenix, Kanchipuram, New York, Varanasi, Chennai, Alvarpet, Singapore, Singapuram, Slovakia, Košice, Mahakumbapuri, Prayag, Troy, Michigan, Dubai, Tirukkovilur, Hyderabad, Sri, East London, UK, Bangalore, Marat, Bannirghatta, Bresenton, Bridgetown, Barbados, Black Diamond, Canada, Bangalore, Gangamma Circle, Hyderabad, Sri, East London, UK, Slovakia, Košice, Laspet, Pondicherry, Torax, Spain, Port Washington, New York, St. Louis, Tirumala, Charlotte, Srisailam, Wellington, New Zealand, Hong Kong, Sirgari, Oman, Sivagangai, San Diego, Tiruvallavai, Chennai, Mahalingapuram, Atlanta, Ujjaini, Devon, UK, Paris, Kaligat, Chicago, Srirangam, London, Kashi, Monterrey, Mexico, Oman, Sivagangai, Hong Kong, Sirgari, Vancouver, Puri, Bangalore, Marathahalli, right? Auckland, New Zealand, that is Bangalore, Malleshwaram or Marathahalli? Bangalore, Malleshwaram. Prananda and Mathurya on the way to Chennai in the bus. Ma, next to Vancouver, Puri, is it Bangalore, Malleshwaram or Marathahalli? Bangalore, Malleshwaram, are you able to hear me or not? Come on. If you are not going to move the hand or wave, I will not know whether you are able to hear me. Auckland, New Zealand. That's it. And London, Kashi. I can see now London, Kashi. Yes. I welcome all of you. And Wellington, New Zealand. I can see Wellington, New Zealand also. I welcome all of you with my love and blessings. Today, Nirahara Samyama, third level, 10th day. Di Samyama, 7th day. Inner awakening and ingenious, 7th day. मैं आप सबको प्रेम व आशीर्वाद सहित स्वागत करता हूँ. सो बिफोर एंटरिंग इनटू द सत्संग टुडे फ्यू अनाउंसमेंट्स. अवर महाकुंभपुरी द टेम्पररी आश्रम विल बी फंक्शनिंग ओनली टिल दिस पौर्णमी. पौर्णमी डेट मीन्स 26th. Only till 20, this Pauranami, this Shahi Snan, it will be functioning because the authorities, Kumbhamela authorities, are winding up slowly. They are expecting monsoon little early. The whole area will be flooded actually. So they are reducing the electricity infrastructure and all that. They are asking all big tents to slow down their activities, and there is only one more Shahi Snan, March 10th. After this Shahi Snan of 20, this coming Purnami, there is only one more Shahi Snan. So everybody is reducing their activity. In our case, we decided we will wind up the tent by 25th February, Mahi Purnima. Mahi Purnima Snan will be 25th February. 26th, 27th itself, we will start winding up. Any devotees wanted to go for Kumbh Mela and stay in our tent, please finish it off in next few days. And after that, our tent may not be functioning. I wanted to announce it very clearly. Whoever is, if somebody has registered and asked for accommodation, please send the email to them and complete with them. All of them. And I announce now itself and complete with all of you. Of course, from my side, I wanted to be there till March 10th. From the authorities' side, they are reducing. They are winding up. First of all, first thing they are saying is, this time the Kumbhapuri was, Mahakumbhapuri, was built thrice than regular size. And they need at least 1 month to wind up. Otherwise, the whole thing will go under the water, nothing can be retrieved. Winding up is not possible and the river will be polluted. If you have seen, you know, I don't know how many hundreds of kilometer roads have been made with the steel blankets, steel plates, and the steel poles wiring. The whole thing has to be wound up by April 1st week. It will be all flooded. So especially our zone, see, fortunately we got the land in the center of the Kumbhapuri, means first we will be flooded. Where our ashram is there, that will be flooded first. We are in the prime area, so the authorities are requesting us to reduce the activity, and they are not asking us to wind up completely, but they are asking us to start packing up with minimal activity. We decided we also need time, and ours is all huge deities. If there is a sudden flood, you can't move the deities also. It's all ours as usual, heavy duty Hinduism. But ours is heavy duty Hinduism, and I am getting into a sports utility Hinduism. Not just heavy duty, moving to the next level, sports utility Hinduism. So ours is huge deities. All have to be moved. So 26, 27 itself, I told them to start packing. I thank all the volunteers, ashramites, sannyasis, devotees, and Mahanirvani Akada, and everybody who is involved in Kumbh Mela, making this Kumbh Mela as a beautiful experience for all of us. This will be the historical Kumbh Mela, not only for Nityananda Dhyanapeedam, for whole Hinduism. And our Yogalaya, I am naming it as Mahanirvani Akada. We will call our Yogalaya as Mahanirvani Akada. Sambhava, make it as a wooden floor so that it's nice for yoga and all the practices. I wanted people to learn all the things related to body. Yoga, gym, weightlifting, and dance, everything related to body, martial arts, mallakamba, everything related to body. So make the floor that way. And allot an area, specific area for mallakamba. It should be sand. Talk to the mallakamba teacher and how they wanted, make it that way. So the whole hall where everything available. One corner, beautiful gym. One side, the mallakamba for that post, sand, everything. And one side, that open gym. Open gym means the parallel bars and all those things will be there. That with the sand. And the whole remaining area should be wooden floor. All the whole wall should be glassed completely, mirrored, so that people can do Swapurnatu also. Okay? Design it pakka. And you may not need to do any repair on the underground, na? Even when you strengthen the building. Okay, other than that, nothing. Finish it, make it as a pakka professional international standard gym, mallakamba training center, and all the body related things, and even the library. Let the library also be there itself, jnanalaya also be there. That area, whole thing is underground, is allotted for this purpose. Yogalaya and jnanalaya. The whole thing will be called as Mahanirvani Akada. Let all the best things be made available for sannyasis to have the training to their body and mind. And I also have a message from Turiya. The all Akadas have already left for Kashi. As per the tradition, actually I did it without knowing, as per the tradition, after Kumbh Mela you are supposed to go to Kashi. It's called Kashi Pravas. Nirvana Akada is already doing Kashi Pravas. All Mahamandaleshwar, Srimahans, all of them are in Kashi. Winding up has started. We did it. Of course, Kalabhairava is doing. Great. We will also have a traditional Dharma Dvaja established just like Akada here permanently. It is, I think, 55 feet. Do it in steel. You can do it in steel. Look how they are doing. And on that we will have a beautiful flag, Dhyanapitam flag. And I have one more announcement. Seremban Center, Malaysia, out of their love, they released a stamp in Malaysia with my picture. It's actually like anybody can pay to the government and get it released, but it's an official stamp. Means it can be used for posting letters. Yes. This is the Malaysia Seremban Centers with all their with all the devotees signature they sent. Just for memory, it's a good way to remember. Bridgetown, Barbados, Molai Gorai, birthday blessings for you. With all the auspiciousness, you will be with me, I will be with you. Blessings. Let's enter into birthday for Jnana Swarupananda also today. Blessings for Jnana Swarupananda. With all the auspiciousness, you will be with me, I will be with you. Blessings. Next. We'll move to the satsang. I can see the Mexico City center now. Mexico City and Durango, Mexico. Blessings. Come on, let's enter into the satsang. Yesterday, Gurukul Kids had a question or a doubt. Swamiji announced he is going to discuss only the tattvas for next few days. Suddenly he said he is going to speak on Vrajahoma mantras. Is it not lack of integrity? Even if I speak on Vrajahoma mantras, I am going to speak only on the tattvas. So it is not lack of integrity. I just wanted to clarify to our Gurukul kids. And our Gurukul kids have the right to advise me. Our Gurukul kids are my advisory committee. It's an honor I give them for their practicing integrity and authenticity. When you are ahankara, mamakara, merge with each other, you will be able to fulfill others' anyakara. I can say this is a new definition of Sangam. Mamakara is Yamuna, ahankara is Ganga. When both merges, you will be able to fulfill others' anyakara, that is Saraswati. Shraddhavan lapate jnanam. Gita says very clearly in the 4th chapter, 39th verse, Shraddhavan lapate jnanam. The authentic one attains enlightenment. Dhyan se suniye. Shraddhavan lapate jnanam. The authentic one attains enlightenment. Making your ahankara and mamakara merge with each other. Yamuna is the material, Ganga is the name after the merging. If you see the quantity of water, after the Sangam, Yamuna is the largest quantity of water. That is why after the Sangam, the river form is Yamuna's form, color is Yamuna's color, but name is Ganga. Because ahankar, what you show to the outer world, its name will be there, but what you feel as inner world will become strength for what you show to the outer world. Listen. When the mamakara is separate, ahankara is wrong. When the mamakara supports ahankara, it is no more ahankara, it is your being. You can't call ahankara as ahankara if mamakara is supporting it. As long as mamakara and ahankara are separate, you can use the word ahankara, which is wrong. Ego. It is wrong. The moment mamakara supports ahankara, they become one with each other. It is no more ego, it is e-go. Or it is n-go. again and again and again. Strengthen your mamakara with the qualities you project as ahankara. Strengthen your ahankara by using all the thinking power mamakara has it. Listen, ahankara as expression power, mamakara as experience power. When there is a lack of integrity, both of them are separate. When you integrate, both of them are one and the same. Your mamakara as the experience power means experiencing what you think as you, what you as you. Your ahankara as expression power, declaring yourself, asserting yourself. Integrate both of them. Then whatever you project or declare as you, you will become that. That is what is. Infuse all the qualities of ahankara, what you project as you, as mamakara, feel it as you. If you are declaring to the world, I am strong, intelligent, make that as your mamakara. Yes, I am strong and intelligent. If some part of you is not accepting, weed it out with integrity. That is practicing integrity. Aligning your mamakara to ahankara is practicing integrity. Aligning your ahankara to anyakara, others anyakara, is taking responsibility. Dhyan se suniye. Aligning your mamakara, what you feel as you, to your ahankara, what you project as you, is integrity. Because what you project as you will always be strong, much more than what you think as you. What is the only obstruction for this alignment, this communion? Your negative patterns. For example, you always project yourself as strong, but you don't believe inside you as strong because you have the lack of integrity. That negative commitments given to you, I am weak, I am a failure, no, no. Complete all that, no. I am not going to honor the negative commitments I have given to me as I am a failure, as I am wrong. I am declaring, I am committing with myself, I am a winner, I am a success, I am Shiva, Mangalatva. It is very unfortunate. Vedantis carry a strong pattern saying, no, I should be ready to accept failure because failure is part of life. No. Then constantly you are giving a commitment to you, there is going to be failure. There is going to be failure. The expectation of failure. Listen. Dhyan se suniye. How many of you cognize what I am saying? Preparation for the Shamadama, Tidiksha, does not need to give you the negative commitments. Preparation to be balanced all the moments does not need to give you the negative expectation. Clear? How many of you listen? Dhyan se suniye. Bhakta, go for tea. Hindi word for all this. Regularly using terms. I wanted to give a new name for tea, the nectar of sleeplessness. So put it in Hindi, the word for Kutake Shamruta, something like that. Nectar first, come up with the Hindi word for it. Anyhow, listen. You always internally prepare yourself for any facing any failure. Am I right? Facing any failure that does not need to strengthen your belief that you are going to have failure. It does not need to strengthen. Listen. How many of you have the habit of mentally preparing yourself for the eventualities of failures? Raise your hand. Great. Now listen. When you prepare, usually you remind the worst situations, worst possibilities, and prepare weapons, tools to handle it. Am I right? But unfortunately, whenever you remember those worst possibilities, you give that as a commitment to you. Have awareness. Now decide. Listen. You never handled worst possibilities because of preparation. You always handled worst possibilities because of your completion. If you are in the space of completion, you face the worst possibilities in completion, win and come out successfully. You never handled the worst possibilities successfully because of your preparation. How much ever you prepare, when the eventuality comes, you have collapsed. How many of you agree, cognize, even with all your preparations, when the eventuality comes, you collapse? How many of you cognize? Raise your hand. So, all your preparation, you are preparing for the worst fire accident, but the earthquake happens. Then you start preparing for earthquake, then flood happens. You get ready with all the insurance for the flood. Insurance agency goes bankrupt. Listen. It is power of completion empowers you to face the worst eventualities. You have put the wrong trust. How many of you cognize with what I am saying? I said there are 14 scriptures of Saiva Siddhanta. I told them, get me those books. They were wondering, why you are asking? I said, I wanted few words and concepts from Siddhanta, because 2 days before, Kalabhairava was telling me, and one of our volunteers sent me a message in the Facebook, a doubt on a Vedantic book, Tamil Vedantic book, Nana Jivavada Kattalai. Paripurani, you sent it now. She sent a doubt. When I was scanning to answer her, but of course I have not answered her in the Facebook, I found there are some deepest knots are not opened by Vedantic literatures. Maybe it was not recorded in book, only the guru disciple way. As a Karana Parampara, it was getting transmitted. So I don't have a reference for solution for this problem. Evening, when I went to Kalabhairava, I did not ask as a question, but that was there in my inner space. Kalabhairava suddenly revealed, this is the knot, catch it and tell people. I don't know whether yesterday night or day before yesterday night this happened. When did you send the message, ma? Day before yesterday. Then I think day before yesterday it happened. Because I was contemplating on her message, on her question, she had a doubt. The doubt is not directly related to this problem. The doubt is a different problem. When I was digging deep, why the Vedanta did not sought answer this problem, it landed on this root. Now the problem which I am discussing with you guys, preparation for the worst eventualities mentally strengthens your faith, your belief, the negative commitment to yourself, the worst eventualities are going to happen. How many of you cognize this now? Okay? Are you successful by preparation, handling any eventualities? How many of you fail? You are not successful. So from today, you will not prepare yourself for the worst eventualities mentally. You will spend all your energy by removing the weed of the worst eventuality from your inner space. How many of you cognize it? So, Shantamaya, you don't understand? Removing the belief the worst eventuality is going to happen. Understand? Now you are getting it? Listen, because if there is going to be any worst eventuality, it is always going to be happening the way you can never imagine. Clear? So the completion is the shield. Not preparation. Fort is not going to save you from death, but enlightenment is going to save you from death. You go on building fort, but Yama just comes and picks you up, takes you away. You are doing, see, Parikshit did two things when he knows he is going to die. Listening to Bhagavata and building a huge fort. Bhagavata saved him, not the fort. Dhyan se suniye. Parikshit was given a curse. It's a beautiful story from Mahabharata. Parikshit is our great-grandfather, because his grandson, I don't know whether son or grandson, is Bharat. Bharata. Can you just Google and tell? In his name only the country is called as Bharata. Bharat. Parikshit was given a curse. That he will be bitten by a snake and die in 7 days. He was doing all the preparations to face the worst eventuality. Building a huge fort in the center of the ocean, overnight they built it. But fortunately, he had wise people around him and he had a sense to listen to wise people. Sugabrahma says, Parikshittu, preparing for the worst eventualities is not going to be the foolproof way to escape from the worst eventuality. Get ready with completion. Sugabrahma was his Rajaguru, and he was also ready to listen to the Rajaguru. He said, "Right, oh my Lord." Sugabrahma and Vyasa have the title of Bhagavan because they are incarnations. Sugabrahma has one more title, Paramahamsa. I have a great connection with Sugabrahma because my gurus, Anyakara about me, was Sugabrahma. Kuppammal, she constantly will say, "You should be like Sugabrahma, and you are Sugabrahma." That's why she gave me the name, Diksha name, when she declared I am an incarnation as Brahma Sughi. That was the name she gave. Sugabrahma. So Sugabrahma says, be prepared with completion. Parikshit listens to the master. Finally, see what happened. All his preparations for the worst eventuality failed. Daksha came and beat him and killed him. But because of his intelligence, he prepared with a completion. Listening to the story of Bhagavata saved him. He became enlightened. He was liberated. So the completion saves you from worst eventualities. I tell you, keeping Kala Bhairava as a witness, if this guy has done only completion, did not attend to this preparing for the worst eventualities, that's time also you would have saved. You would have done something more, I tell you, even the death would not have happened. He could have done little more plannings, some prayaschitta. He could have avoided even the death. I think he was doing both. So his inner space was not completely with completion. I tell you, whenever you prepare for worst eventualities, you give negative commitment to you, which weakens you, makes you powerless. How many of you cognize this? So from today, all of us commit to Kala Bhairava that no more question of constantly preparing mentally for the worst eventualities and strengthening the negative prophecies. Only completion, completion, completion. And power, feeling powerful to face anything without imagining what may come, may not come. How many of you are ready to commit? Great. This is one of the important click. How many of you feel this is one of the important click? Moksha Priyan has a question. What is the difference between planning for the worst scenario and planning for any bad scenario? Is Swami saying we only plan for successful outcomes then, and along with that be ready for any unknown eventuality? Moksha Priyan, I am very clear, just plan for successful outcomes, nothing else. With your whole ahankara and mamakara, with integrity, you will have only successful outcomes. Just stand by it. Just stand by it. Just stand by it. There is no if or but. Life has no if or but our fear does not allow even to think there is a space where there is no if or but. The space of no if and but. Is enlightenment. If is Swadhisthana, but is Muladhara. If is Swadhisthana, but is Muladhara. All ifs are out of Swadhisthanam. All but is from Muladhara. All no is from Manipuraka. All may is also from Manipuraka. For many people, it is Manipuraka. Manipuraka. Not Manipuraka. Do not prepare for the worst eventualities, because you are constantly strengthening, giving a negative commitment to you that worst eventuality is going to happen. Even you need to prepare, tell yourself, I am not giving the negative commitment to me that worst eventuality is going to happen. Consciously, again and again, complete every time. Listen. Understand? Listen. Consciously complete with yourself. Even if I am preparing for it, even in the deepest unconscious of me, subconscious of me, indirectly or directly, I am not committing with me, I am not going to believe, I am not committing that this negativity is going to happen to me, that this negativity will be made to happen in me, in my life, I am not committing. I am committing with me, authentically, with integrity, I am a winner. I am successful person. I win. I succeed. Part of you will say, no, 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 no. If. You say, no, 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 there is no if. It will just say, no, 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 if. No, 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 there is no if. How many of you cognize exactly, this is what goes on in me? A man who can see what goes on in every being's inner space, like CCTV camera, is antaryami. This is what Krishna means when he says, I am the antaryami in all of you. Means he knows what goes on in all of us and he gives solution for it. How many of you feel, I just sat inside you and got the footage and giving solution for it? So be very clear, for all of you, I am Antaryami. So now if you do the Manasa Puja, Hridbadma Masanam Dadyat, it's an authentic experience. Now you know I am the Antaryami. This is what is the meaning of the word Antaryami. One who resides in the innermost space. Today sit and complete just with this one pattern. Take this as homework. Because this is one of the important pattern with which everyone suffers. Mapriya is sending a question. Can you explain, can you please clarify the difference between this complete cognition and the so-called positive thinking? No, so-called positive thinking is always positive negative thinking. Listen, usually your thinking is negative positive thinking. In positive thinking, you have positive negative thinking. Only in this complete cognition, you have positive experiencing. Where the deep wound, where you started believing the negativity is going to be lifestyle of you, is can be healed only in complete cognition. Positive thinking cannot heal your strong belief the failure is going to be part of your life. Understand? Positive thinking can be fighting with the negativity, can never heal the negativity. This complete cognition will heal the negativity. How many of you are cognizing it? Listen, your ordinary thinking is negative positive. Negative positive means usually negative, rarely you think positively. Positive thinking is like a consciously you try to be positive but fall into negative. Then again start positive, fall into negative. This is complete cognition. I call it Puranatva. With this Puranatva, your strong negative beliefs itself will be healed. How many of you are cognizing it? How many of you are excited to go and practice this? The most violent, powerless beings on the planet Earth are suicidal tendency people. The most violent people on the planet Earth are murderers. Most violent and powerless people on the planet Earth are suiciders. Dhyan se suniye, keval purnatva ke siti द्वारा ही आप अपने नकारात्मक संभावनाओं को जीत पाएंगे. ध्यान से सुनिए, केवल पूर्णत्व की स्थिति द्वारा ही आप अपने नकारात्मक संभावनाओं के जीत पाएंगे. I can understand actually. Not only I am repeating the word, understand. Nakaratmak. That's a negative thinking. Am I right? Nakaratmak. I'll just develop the pronunciation, that's all. But all the satsangis and samajis, thank you for putting up with my training. Your patience, which you show during my training period, is the dedication you give it for the future generation which are going to listen to my Hindi satsangs. I have one more question from Singapore. Is positive thinking a kind of deliberate conscious ahamkara building? I tell you, a deliberate conscious building being built without foundation. So any time it will collapse, when it collapses, the damage will be too much. A small earthquake is enough to collapse the whole thing, the damage will be too much. केवल पूर्णत्वा की स्थिति द्वारा ही आप अपने नकारात्मक संभावनों को जीत पाएंगे. नॉट बाय सकारात्मक संभावनों के जीत. ध्यान से सुनिए. श्रद्धावान लपते ज्ञानम. Unite the ahankara and mamakara. What are the major obstructions for ahankara and mamakara uniting? One of the important wedge between ahankara and mamakara is constantly preparing for the negative eventuality. Am I right? How many of you cognize it? If that wedge is removed, I tell you, if that wedge is removed, I'll have thousands of people as sannyasis. Why do people don't become sannyasis? The fear of negative eventualities. Nakaratmak sampavanoko. Nakaratmak sampavana. Negative possibility. All of you listen. Today what you all received is Kalabhairava Prasada. Understand? It's a Kalabhairava Prasada. After the satsang, go and have his darshan, take his blessings, commit in front of him that I am going to complete this pattern as your prasada and complete it today. Yesterday, one of my brahmachari was telling me, when I start doing Swapurnatva, so much of suffering is coming out, I feel like I just want to run away from here. I told him, you don't need to run away. You tell me any place where you go, this suffering will not chase you. I'll give you the money and send you there by a private chartered flight. You don't need to run away. You show me a single place where you go, this suffering will not chase you. Why should you run away? I will give you the money and arrange for everything and take you there. Dhyan se suniye. Sakaratmak sonj se nahi balki keval purnatva sthiti se hai apke नकारात्मक संभावनाओं को जीत पाएंगे. सकारात्मक सोच से नहीं बल्कि केवल पूर्णत्व स्थिति से ही आप आपके नकारात्मक संभावनाओं को जीत पाएंगे। Just by completion alone, just by completion alone, life is faced. Never by any preparation for the worst eventualities. Please listen. Only when they feel responsible, they become human beings. Listen, till the chicken is able to come out of the egg and find its own food, the hen is responsible for hatching it. Till the cub starts hunting on its own and finding the food and all the survival techniques, the lion or lioness is responsible. Till you learn responsibility, I am responsible. Understand, only when you learn responsibility, you become a human being. Till you become human being, as a human being, I am responsible for making you a human being. Hen cannot say that I will not make this egg into chicken and chicken to hen. Each one of you are only egg. The possibility, till you become hen, till you become chicken and hen, as a hen, I am responsible. How many of you are catching it? Yes, this is what is shvasraddha, means when many of your own patterns are dead, you do shraddha for yourself. And then take sannyas. Only a person who has killed all his patterns can take sannyas doing vrajahoma. Listen. Because before the vrajahoma, you have to do shraddha for yourself. Atma shraddha, it is called. You declare you are dead and you do all the last rites for yourself. You can do last rites for yourself if you have killed all the root thought patterns you are carrying. Now the pain always resists. Dhyan se suniye. Completion is the only solution. Even to handle others' inauthenticity, completion only gives you courage. The lion or lioness is responsible for the cub till the cub learns to hunt on its own. Unable to survive. If the lion or lioness disowns the cub, I tell you, by the nature of lioness, it cannot disown. By nature of me, I cannot disown you. Don't worry. I can only wait. I cannot give up on you. Maybe you will be wasting few janmas, but I will not be able to give up on you. I'll wait. I'll wait. And I'll continue to wait. The ultimate sacrifice is sometimes lioness forces the cub to fight with itself, acting as if lioness is angry and attacking the cub to teach the cub how to fight, how to hunt. It may give its own tail for you to learn to bite. Even this is not ultimate sacrifice. What is ultimate sacrifice, you know? When the lioness turns on the when the cub is trying to bite the tail, tolerating is not ultimate sacrifice. When the lioness turns and shows the face, and out of that fear, the survival mode is awakened and the cub jumps on the lioness. And lioness will be laughing inside, in the heart. That is ultimate sacrifice. Cub does not even know the plan of the lioness. Cub thinks lioness is attacking me and I have to win, I have to attack. Cub can never win the lioness. But just by making the cub attack, lioness feels he has won. Lioness, she has won the ultimate winning. She is successful in making the cub attack back. Now she knows he will survive. He has become me. Even when we see utter inauthenticity in others, when we take responsibility for it, we become leaders. Life oozes through us. ध्यान से सुनिए. पूर्ण स्थिति एवं उपायनम के द्वारा ही आपके मनुष्य का जीवन जीने लगते हैं और संपूर्ण तारा से मनुष्य के लाता है कहलाता है. Every time when you are split, you are asking for one more person to fight with you. Listen, not to share the work. When you are split and you are fighting with yourself constantly, you feel it is too much. If you have one more person, it is easy to fight with him. You will be a little relieved. It is just a change of fighter. You need not assistant. Only when you are complete, even if one more person is given, he will be assistant. If not, there will be only stunt. Not assistant. When you are incomplete, even if there is one more person, there will only be stunt. They will not be assistant. Every time when somebody opens up with the completion, they only feel load. How many of you feel, oh God, I have loads, tons and tons to complete? Raise your hand. But I tell you, if you complete just few kgs, so many tons will suddenly disappear. Why, you know? The incompletion is not in mass volume. It is just a sheet covering. This lion is not solid inside. It is only sheet covering. When you see from outside, it looks so huge. But when you start completing, it's only the sheet. How many of you catching it? It is not solid statue. It's a sheet metal piece. Your incompletions are sheet metal piece, not solid volume material. When you start doing it, you will understand. You will, from outside, you will not believe it is not a solid statue. But you will feel, oh, so heavy, how will I lift? It is sheet. The heap of your incompletion is just polythene sheet of incompletion. Start, you will understand. You think, no, it may be for others. You don't know my incompletion stuff. I know what you know and what you don't know. Both. It is like mother is asking the child, hey, are you eating the chocolate? You are not supposed to eat. The child keeps the chocolate behind, holding behind the back. No, I don't have chocolate. I don't have chocolate. He doesn't understand. Mother can just see through behind what you are holding in your hand. She is tall. Just, I commit with you guys. Same way, within a year, I'll start speaking fluently Kannada also. Even now, I can do personal conversations. I'll pick it up. I'll pick up more then. Let's come back to the subject. Heal. Do completion. I tell you, the demon who is sitting inside your body and enjoyed your body and mind for quite a long time will not even allow you to do completion. How many of you feel you don't even want to do completion at some times? Well, you know, because those demons, he lived in your body for quite a long time. Now you are saying, get out. Why he will get out? He will tell, let him get out. Let Swami get out. Why should I get out? He is a new tenant. I am a old tenant. I am living here for ages. Just because somebody new is coming, you are asking me to get out. You can do Viraja Homa only after Atma Shraddha. Shvashratta means doing last rites for yourself. You can do last rites for yourself only if you have destroyed all the root thought patterns. So before Shivaratri, you have to complete destroying, completing all the root thought patterns. How many of you commit, you will be ready. God. Great. Prepare yourself. Great. Otherwise, wait for the Guru Purnima batch, second batch. Or wait for the third batch. This is the real sannyas, understand? Real sannyas. Destroying the root thought patterns. completing with root thought patterns and doing Atma Shraddha. If you destroy the root thought patterns, you can do Atma Shraddha and you are ready for sannyas. If you destroy yourself, you have done Atma Hadya, you are ready for hell. I have a question. Swamiji, you asked us to do completion as a process, as a technique many times today. Could you explain one or two lines the technique for the completion if possible? Listen, I never asked you to do the completion as a technique. I only say completion as a process. Technique means you go in and come out as it is, as you are. In process, you go and come out as a new person. There's a big difference between technique and process. Technique has no conscious involvement. Just blow the nose this many times. Process has a conscious involvement. It evolves while you do it. Let me define the process of completion. If somebody else is also involved, sit with the person. If that person is not available for some reason, sit with mirror. Invoke that person on the other side of the mirror. If there is no other person involved, only you need to complete with you. Already other person, you are there in the other side of the mirror. Sometime you may have to do with you and somebody involved, invoking that person also in the mirror. So first you do with you and then invoke that person in the mirror and do. Listen. Now I am giving you the method for the process of Swapurnatva with you. Identify your source of inauthenticity, the repetitive pattern or the inauthenticity. Invoke that person on the mirror. Literally do. Tell your name. Iha gaccha, iha gaccha, iha tishta, iha tishta, iha sannidehi, iha sannidehi, iha sannirudhyasva, iha sannirudhyasva, iha sannmugibhava, iha sannmugibhava. Atradhishtanam kurumama dhyanagrihanam. Invoke your inauthenticity, your incomplete on the mirror by doing pranapratishta. Talk to that person. Heal that person. Make him as part of you by befriending that person. And till he accepts and understands his inauthenticities and declares he will become part of you, supporting you, living with you, enriching you, becoming you. Do the process. Talk, talk, talk it out. If you have to do completion with somebody else who is not available to you physically, then again, sit with the mirror. If you have to do Swapurnatva and Purnatva with the other person through mirror, don't sit the same mirror. Move to the next mirror. If you have invoked yourself in a mirror, don't invoke the other person in the same mirror. Just move to the next mirror. Invoke the other person. Same pranapratishta process. With integrity and authenticity, and I invoke your energy here with which I need to do the completion. You will see he is there and do the completion. You may even receive suddenly a phone call from that person. He wants to talk to you and complete with you. You do not know the power of completion. Just try this one. If you have something to complete with me, invoke me in the mirror and do. When you see me next time, when I see you next time, my eyes, my behavior, my attitude, my words to you, everything will be different. I'll prove it, then you will know the power of this completion. Manishananda says, it is true, he has experienced it. Sri Manisha. And you know how to invoke me? Just do the prana pratishtha, I am there. And species on the planet Earth. Completion alone is the shield to protect yourself in future from everything. Completion alone is the sword to win in every situation of your life. Completion is the sword and shield. How many of you feel even though you resist completion, you don't want to do completion, you fight with completion, you suffer with completion, you know after the process you are going to be liberated, you are going to be free, you are going to be a better person. Then do it. Sahajananda, then do it. That is the beauty of completion. Even when you fight with me, you know you are in my lap. I hold your nose not to kill you, but to teach you to breathe through the mouth and ears also. Completion, space of completion is a shield and sword for your life. Do it. Do it. Do it. Space of completion is a Brahma Kapala Shiva carries. Any incompletion, drop it in that, it will swallow it. It will destroy it. It will eat it away. Space of completion is the Brahma Kapala Mahakala carries. Any incompletion, drop it in that. It will swallow it. Carry the space of completion. That is Ananda Gandha, Pratyagatma Chaitanya. Listen, I am redefining our programs. You have to be introduced to four tattvas in LBP level 1. And you have to be taught to find the root patterns and make four tattvas as a lifestyle in LBP level 2, and you should be living it. Only then you qualify for the LBP level 3, where you are carrying the space of completion so that you can be initiated into Ananda Gandha. Only if you are carrying the space of completion, you can heal others. Your Ananda Gandha is open, alive, active, available to you and to others. I am so excited, feeling powerful, energetic by these four tattvas. I even feel like declaring, I disown all other my teachings other than these four tattvas. I'm not going to declare I will wait, but I feel excited so much. Maybe I can declare anything which supports you to live these four tattvas only, I accept as my teachings. Everything else I disown. These four tattvas and anything which supports you to live these four tattvas, only I accept, not my teachings anymore. In inner awakening, we will be making that person live these four tattvas and able to go and teach and make others live these four tattvas. In inner awakening, the person has to become Jivan Mukta. When he goes back, his family, society, team, the whole people, whole group around him, whoever comes in his breathing space should live these four tattvas. Only then you had inner awakening. Or you just wasted your time in inner dirtying with any man, everything else. Each organizer, each volunteer, each devotee, each visitor to our temple should be just living these four tattvas. Should be just living these four tattvas. Each inner awakening graduate should be radiating these four tattvas so powerfully in your life. Everybody around you should be just start living these four tattvas. Every dog in our campus, every grass in our campus should bark these four tattvas, should radiate these four tattvas. Every grass should dance with these four tattvas. It is completion which is a sword and shield. Purnatva sthiti hi aapke jivan ko surakshit rakhne wali. Dalva talwar dono hai. Purnatva sthiti hi aapke keval jivan ko surakshit rakhne wali. डाल व तलवार दोनों है. पूर्णत्व स्थिति ही केवल आपके जीवन को सुरक्षित रखने वाली. डाल व तलवार दोनों है. शील्ड एंड द सोर्ड आर नॉट टू. आई ऑल्सो कमिट विथ ऑल यू गाइस. From today, I'll type at least few statuses in Hindi in my Facebook. Means I'll type in English, but Hindi statements in transliteration. Completion is the sword and the shield. Completion is the Brahma Kapala. If you see Kala Bhairava, he will be carrying the Brahma Kapala in his hand. The completion is the Brahma Kapala. Offer anything incomplete into it, it will swallow. Let us bring authenticity. and integrity, responsibility and enrichment, enriching. केवल पूर्णत्व स्थिति ही आपके जीवन को सुरक्षित रखने वाली डाल व तलवार दोनों है, एक ही है पूर्णत्व स्थिति। When you are carrying the space of completion, listen. You are in the lap of Mahadeva. Nothing can touch you. You will always be successful. Even Garuda cannot touch the snake which is in Mahadeva's neck. I declare till the time of Guru Purnima, next few months as the months of completion, season of completion, Purnatva Ritu. So from tomorrow in the Sankalpa Mantra you will read it out as Purnatva Rutuhu till Guru Purnima, so that constantly everybody is reminded in the season of completion. Clear? Now actually it is Vasanta Rutu, am I right? Shishira Rutu. So you will read out as Purnatva Rutu till Guru Purnima. Purnatva Rutuhu. We'll move to the next segment of the morning satsang with this.